Hey, Jill.
It's been abandoned for a while. Hey. I don't think we're alone. There's blood coming from the ducts. It's not working. Parker, give me a hand here.
Sure, no problem.
I got something. I think it's a gun.
Now what?
Give me a sec.
So, it's not Chris.
This explains our missing crew.
This is not good. Where are you, Chris?
Thank you.
This sunny and idyllic Mediterranean coast was the site of one of the world's greatest structures. It took a full 11 years to finish constructing the world's first aquapolis, the floating city of Terra Grigia. A sustainable metropolis operating on a massive solar energy matrix and equipped with the latest green technologies. Never before had solar energy been used to supply power to an entire city. But in 2004, Veltro, a terrorist group opposing the city's development, launched a bioterrorist attack. They not only released a virus, but also several creatures, known as bioorganic weapons, further complicating the situation. This launched one of the worst tragedies the world has ever seen. The FBC, the world's leading counter-bioterror organization operating under the auspices of the US, was called in to direct efforts to contain the attack. The BSAA, a counter-bioterror NGO, which operates independently of the interests of any one country, went in as observers to assist the FBC. Realizing the need for immediate and decisive action, Supreme Local Headquarters issued the order to use the city's solar energy matrix on itself. Media outlets around the world began to refer to the incident as the Terra Grigia Panic. Following the incident, the FBC announced it has successfully disbanded the terrorist group called Veltro. It is now 2005, and a sense of calm and security is finally returning to the people. But, as you can see, the lost city of Terra Grigia remains inaccessible, a silent and potent symbol of the threat that bioterror poses for people around the world.
There you two are.
O'Brien, you don't normally join the fray.
Well, my doctor told me I need exercise. I assume you both know that the FBC has cordoned off the entire area. However, in the past few weeks, a number of mysterious carcasses have washed up.
I guess the FBC couldn't cover up a mess this big, huh?
Anyone who knows what happened here is gonna put two and two together.
And that's why I've sent the BSAA in to investigate. Did you pick up your new equipment from Quint?
The Genesis or something. Is that its name?
You didn't bother to read the manual, did you?
No, I brought it with me, just in case.
I hope you read quickly, because you're gonna need it on your mission.
Yeah, I'm on it.
Genesis requires a decent sample size to get an accurate reading. Scan the carcasses on the beach and send me your data. Ah, look at this mess. Oh, they're rotted to hell.
I'm getting something from inside it.
Move!
Don't worry, we're on.
I suppose. So why'd you quit the FBC for this outfit?
I don't pay you to play, I pay you to work. We don't have enough data to run a complete analysis. Gather some more samples for the type of analysis.
I've collected enough samples.
Good. Get them to me ASAP. Enough chit-chat. Get that sample data to me.
There you are. Nice work.
No doubt about it. These corpses show signs of viral infection.
And I bet it's no coincidence they came through the FBC's blockade.
Well, we did all we can. Now, we wait for the results to come back from HQ. Huh? It's the emergency line. Yeah, it's me. Uh-huh. What? Yes, that's fine. I'll take it from here. We'll have to speed things up. Starting now. Uh-huh. Good. Get to it. Jill, Parker. You two are still on the case.
What happened?
We lost contact with Chris and Jessica.
When? How?
We're not certain. I've sent their last known coordinates to your terminals.
The signal was lost over the ocean. I thought they were in the mountains chasing Veltro. But judging from their position, they must be...
on a ship. I'll go back to HQ, take charge of the search and rescue. You two will be my eyes out there.
Yes, sir.